What is up, guys? I'm Peter Cole, and welcome back to Skyrim Special Edition. This time, we're going to head up to the next quest. We're supposed to go to Whiterun, which we are at right now, go into Dragon's Reach, and try to capture a dragon to learn more about Alduin. So let's get into it. All right, and we'll just head up there. The Dawn God. Yes, they are reforming the Dawn God. We'll probably get to see them after we do all the other stuff in this game. We'll do that. Wow, I don't know why I ran that way. Like, I already know that that's not the way to run, but for some reason I still did anyway. This game is beautiful. Like, what?
Ulfred, patron of the great clan.
How did I just discover this? That doesn't make sense. I've totally been in Dragon's Reach before. That's super weird. What the heck? I have no idea why that was like that. Battleborn. Alright. Old Frick. Storm Cloak. That's not his name.
Watch over your bat. What is it that you need?
Okay, yeah, wait. I need your help. I need to trap a dragon in your palace.
I must have misheard you. I thought you asked me to help you trap a dragon in my palace.
You know, I wouldn't ask if it was important. Let's try this, the persuade one.
I'm sorry, but I can't do it.
Aww.
We just have to keep fighting the dragons as best we can. What you're asking? You want me to let a dragon into the heart of my city with the threat of war on my doorstep?
It's the only way to stop the dragon attacks.
There must be another way. The risk is too great.
The threat is worse than you know. Alduin has returned.
Alduin? The world eater himself? But how can we fight him? Doesn't his return mean it's the end times?
Nah, bro, I got you. I'm Dragonborn. It's my destiny to stop him.
I don't know about such things. But I heard the Greybeards summon you. That's good enough for me.
Very faithful people.
Now, what's this nonsense about trapping?
What's this nonsense? It's the only way to find Alduin before it's too late.
I want to help you, Dragonborn. And I will. But I need your help first.
With what?
Ulfric and General Tullius are both just waiting for me to make a wrong move.
Oh no.
They will sit idle while the dragon is slaughtering my men and burning my city?
Why would I do that?
No. I can't risk weakening the city while we are under the threat of enemy attack. I'm sorry.
What if you didn't have to worry about an enemy attack?
Then I would be glad to help you with your mad dragon trapping scheme. But getting both sides to agree to a truce will be difficult at this point. The bitterness has gone too deep. Maybe. What of the Greybeards? They are respected by all Nords. High Hrothgar is neutral territory.
Hmm.
If the Greybeards were willing to host a peace council, then maybe Ulfric and Tullius would have to listen.
Leave that to me. I'll talk to Arngeir about hosting a peace council.
Aye, Dragonborn. Maybe you can stop the dragons and this war into the bargain.
Alright.
Now, if you don't mind, I've got a city to keep.
Alright, so, that means that I believe we've now started Season Unending. The Jarl of Whiterun won't help me capture a dragon as long as the Civil War is raging. If I can get the Greybeards to host a peace council, I can try to convince the Imperials and Stormcloaks to agree to a truce in order to defeat Alduin, who is a threat to both sides in the Civil War. Alright, so that's the quest we will be doing, Season Unending. I think at this point, I'm going to have to go talk to both sides, and I have not chosen a side yet. So I'm hoping that I don't have to choose a side. I think I want to do the Stormcloaks and go through their storyline for this playthrough, just to... Because I think it's funny to play the... Or not funny, but fun. To play the underdog and to be able... Wow, that's kind of fitting that it shows his picture there. To play the underdog and kind of see the story of, like, freeing themselves and stuff like that. Not talking about which side I think should be the one, but I went Stormcloaks first just because I think it's cool, like I said, to be able... Ooh, this has more stuff in it? Oh no, just the supplies that the guy never took out. even though it's been like forever. I think it's cool to be able to play the underdog and kind of be like, yeah, we're fighting away the Imperials and everything, especially because I do hate the elves, the Almer. No, that's not their names. What are the names of the elves? I can't remember what the names are. But yeah, I don't like whichever one those are, the evil elves that are like, basically, we're so strong, we can take over all of you guys. Really don't like them, so being able to fight with the Stormcloaks and basically like, screw you guys is pretty cool, even though the Empire with the elves could totally just destroy Skyrim, even if they tried to stop them.
Alduin? We heard the Dragonren shout from here. You defeated him?
Yes, but he escaped. I need to find his portal to Sovngarde.
I feared as much. I thought it was him we saw flying east after your battle.
Sorry, guys. I'm a bit of a disappointment. I need your help. I need to capture a dragon.
We are not warriors. What is overlooked in the Dragonborn is not permitted to any other followers of the Way of the Voice.
I'll worry about capturing a dragon. I need your help to stop the war.
You misunderstand our authority. The Greybeards have never involved themselves in political affairs.
Yar Bulgruff won't help me while the war rages.
I see. The dragon will lead you to Alduin, but without the Jarl's help.
Yeah. Both sides respect the Greybeards. They will listen.
Partanax has made the decision to help you. This is the road we have to walk.
I love this guy's voice.
The Greybeards must bend to the winds of change, it seems. So be it. Tell Ulfric and General Tullius that the Greybeards wish to speak to them. We will see if they still remember us.
All right. I mean, they should, right? All right. Let's go talk to them.
Sky above, voice within.
Actually, let's talk to him really quick. Sky above. Are you ready to host the Beast Council?
Deliver the message to the warring parties. If they will listen, I will do what I can to bring them to terms.
Where has Alduin gone?
The old tales say that he can travel into Sovngarde to devour the souls of the dead. You must find out how he does this before he regains his
That's messed up. Basically, like, yeah, he can go into the afterworld, and these people who are trying to be peaceful after they died just totally get devoured anyway.
Sky, got you.
Got you. Get out of my way. Little things. Yeah, so I thought so. We are going to have to go to both Windhelm and I believe Solitude is where General Tullius is. And we're going to have to talk to both of the main leaders of the different sides. And I'm hoping they don't make me choose. What? Was he like right up there or something? Where the heck did he say that from? I just heard, Boozrona! Weird. Alright, so I say first, I believe we've discovered Solitude, but I don't know if I've just... Yeah, I haven't discovered Windhelm yet. I have been to the Windhelm Stables, though, so... Yeah, we'll head to Solitude first, then, and try to talk to General Tullius, who should be able to be... I'm really hoping... I can't remember exactly, because, like I said, it's been a long time since I've played this. But I'm really hoping that he doesn't make me join. They don't make me join sides. I don't think they will, because that would mean that you'd have to choose right now, partway through the story, who you side with. And why would the other person come with you? It wouldn't make sense. So I don't think he will. I'm hoping he won't. We'll get lucky. And Solitude it is. That is the cool thing about Skyrim, is it does feel really lived in. Oh yeah, he's up here. I forgot. Where all the fortresses. Like, there's people just ever. Why are they all running?
Damn dragons could swoop down at any time.
What is that guy doing? And then he just stops. Oh, great. Yeah. That totally. Whoa. What's happening right now? I don't know. You guys tell me, what is it? I don't even know what's going on right now. Y'all just running around by yourselves. Alright, so just in case I am forced to choose a side, I'm gonna make a extra save here really quick. Because I don't know what's about to happen. We'll talk to him.
Are my men now giving free rein to anyone who wanders into the castle?
I'm not anyone.
Do you have some reason to be here, citizen?
I believe we've already met.
Have we? Oh, of course. You are Ed Helgen, one of the prisoners, if I recall correctly.
I was set free. I could have gone anywhere. I came here to fight for the Empire. No, what? No!
I suppose that's true. Fine. Why don't you have a chat with Leggett? I suspect we might have use for someone recently.
Okay, so it does say join.
Not many survived, Helgen.
Woo!
Besides, I'm sure your being imprisoned was all a terrible misunderstanding.
Oh, yeah.
I'm telling you.
Speak with Leggett Ricca. She will determine if you are Legion.
No.
The Greybeards. What do those old hermits want with me?
They're convening a peace council at High Hrothgar. I forgot I didn't read the last one. I said I have a message from the Greybeards.
Why? There's nothing to discuss as long as that traitor Ulfric is in arms against his rightful emperor.
We need a truce until the dragon menace is dealt with.
They are getting to be a problem. But I wasn't sent to Skyrim to fight dragons.
Yeah.
My job is to quell this rebellion, and I intend to do just that. Dragons or no dragons.
The dragons are a bigger problem than the Stormcloaks right now. I'll try this one.
I'll be the judge of that. Besides, by all reports, the Stormcloaks are suffering just as much as we are from these dragon attacks.
The best time to negotiate is from a position of strength. That's true.
Fair enough. We're driving the Stormcloaks back well enough at the moment, but we're already overstretched. That's what comes of trying to win a war with a bare handful of legions. The Ember would just give me the reinforcements I've requested.
Nah, you don't get that lucky. Why won't the Emperor send more reinforcements?
Most of the Legion is tied down on the border with the Aldmeri Dominion.
Aldmeri, that's the name.
The Emperor can't afford to risk weakening Cyrodiil's defenses. From the Imperial City, our war here is just a sideshow. An interlude before the main event against the Thalmor resumes.
Oh, the Thalmor. That's their actual name. Okay. Those guys. Don't like them at all. You'll come to the Peace Council then?
Council. For all the good it will do.
Hey, that's it will do a lot of good, all right? Report, sir. It'll do great. All right, so now we have to go see Ulfric. And another thing I really like about the two different sides is that this is Solitude, and Solitude's kind of cool, but personally, I think Windhelm is way cooler. And that just may be my personal opinion on the matter, but I just think Windhelm is like, it's like the old stone, more Nordic it almost seems like, whereas Solitude seems like the more modern farming type of city. But when you see Windhelm, you'll see what I'm talking about. It's very stone and old looking, and it just looks more rough and like how I would expect a cool Nordic city to look, if that makes sense. So, wow, wrong way. Totally was about to go the opposite direction of the actual place. Get out of my way. Like, just even look into like when you're walking in. So freaking cool. Like, how cool does this place look? Am I right or am I right? It is such an awesome looking place.
You eat our food, you pollute our city with your stink, and you refuse to help the Stormcloaks.
We haven't taken a side because it's not our fight.
Hey, maybe the reason these Greyskins don't help in the war is because they're Imperial spies.
Imperial spies? You can't be serious.
Maybe we'll pay you a visit tonight, little spy. We got ways of finding out what you really are.
Yeah, hate those people though, that's for sure.
Looking for shipping? We always offer better service than the East Empire Company.
Looks like those Nords were giving you trouble.
Nothing new there. Most of the Nords living in Windhelm don't care much for us. But Rolf is the worst by far. He likes to get drunk and walk around the Grey Quarter yelling insults at us in the small hours of the morning. Oh, a real charmer, that.
What a loser. Why would anyone think you're a spy?
Some of these Nords will come up with any excuse to despise us. And it isn't just the Dark Elves they hate. They make a target of the Argonians as well. In fact, just about anyone who isn't a Nord is fair game for their bullying.
So that's one of the things I don't really like about the Stormcloaks, is that a lot of them are either racist or like super intensely nationalistic. Like, it's all about, we just want all Nords, and this is our traditions, and everybody else is evil or on the wrong side. And that is something I'm not a huge fan of. Obviously, it's one of those things where not all the Stormcloaks are like that. But in some places, especially Windhelm, definitely is like that. I know I keep going in the wrong doors. I went in the wrong door for the Greybeards. I went in the wrong door here, but...
Give us a straight answer.
He's a true Nord. He'll come around.
Don't be so sure of that. We've intercepted couriers from Solitude. The Empire's putting a great deal of pressure on Whiterun.
And what would you have me do?
If he's not with us, he's against us.
He knows that. They all know that.
How long are you going to wait?
You think I need to send Borgruff a stronger message?
If by message you mean shoving a sword through his gullet.
Jeez.
Taking his city and leaving him in disgrace would make a more powerful statement, don't you think?
So we're ready to start this war in earnest then?
Soon.
I still say you should take them all out like you did Dead King Torig.
Torig was merely a message to the other Jarls. Whoever we replace them with will need the support of our armies.
We're ready when you are.
Things hinge on Whiterun. If we can take the city without bloodshed, all the better. But if not...
The people are behind you.
Many, I fear, still need convincing.
Very interesting, because we're about to try to make him do a peace treaty.
I remember you. You were at Helgen with us. Come to join the war. Speak with Garmar. He handles the new recruits.
Nah. Yes, good. Sir. Okay, yeah, great.
Speak with Garmar. He'll size you up and see where we can best use your talents.
Yeah, so I have a message from the Greybeards.
It's about time they turned their gaze from the heavens back to our bleeding homeland. What do they want?
They want to negotiate a truce until the dragon menace is dealt with.
I have the greatest respect for the Greybeards, of course. And the dragon attacks are a growing plague. But...
I love his voice.
The political situation is still delicate. Not all the Jarls are fully committed to supporting me as High King. I can't afford to appear weak. I can't agree to this unless Tullius himself...
Glad I went to Tullius first. We'll try the persuade one.
Alduin.
Politics be damned, Alduin has returned.
Of song and legend. If that's true, we're all doomed anyway. And if it isn't true, well, then the fight to free Skyrim goes on. Either way, I don't see the use in talking to the Empire.
Alright. General Tullius has already agreed to attend.
Good. We still hold half of Skyrim despite everything the Empire could throw at us. I doubt the Empire has the stomach for much more bloodletting.
So you'll come to the Peace Council?
Yes. I'll give Tullius one more chance to quit Skyrim with his tail between his legs.
That's not gonna happen at the Peace Council, but
die with their false kings.
We've been soldiers a long time. We know the price of freedom. But people are still weighing things in their hearts.
What's left of Skyrim to wager?
They have families to think of.
How many of their sons and daughters follow your banner? We are their families.
Well put, friend. Tell me, Garmar, why do you fight for me?
I'd follow you into the depths of oblivion. You know that.
Yes, but why do you fight? If not for me, what then?
I'll die before elves dictate the fates of men. Are we not one in this?
I fight for the men I've held in my arms, dying on foreign soil. I fight for their wives and children whose names I heard whispered in their last breath. I fight for we few who did come home, only to find our country full of strangers wearing familiar faces. I fight for my people, impoverished to pay the debts of an empire too weak to rule them, yet brands them criminals for wanting to rule themselves. I fight so that all the fighting I've already done hasn't been for nothing. I fight because I must.
Your words give voice to what we all feel, Ulfric. And that's why you will be High King. But the day words are enough will be the day when soldiers like us are no longer needed.
I will gladly retire from the world were such a day to dawn.
Aye. But in the meantime, we have a war to plan.
That was a nice speech and all, but I love that he just gave this big speech to that one guy, Galmor. He like, I fight because, and he's on this huge rant, but he was the only person there. Why did he even need to rant all about that? You know, it's cool to listen to and all. I mean, I enjoyed it, but there was no reason to go on this long rant and speech just to one guy. I mean, that would have been pretty cool if it was a bunch of Stormcloaks or like, but the guard in the corner's like, oh, this is awesome. I freaking love this guy. I love that behind the door when I open it up, if you look inside between the doors, there's just stone. Like I'm just walking straight into stone. Whoa. Why are we all standing here, guys? What's going on?
So, you've done it. The men of violence
oh, they're already
gathered
here.
In these halls whose very stones are dedicated to peace. I should not have
Sorry.
Agreed to host this council. Greybeards have no business involving ourselves in such matters.
Sorry. Don't worry. I'll get them to agree to peace.
Peace? I doubt it. They may put their weapons down for a moment, but only to gather strength for the next bloodletting.
That's true. I'm going to be a part of it.
They're not yet tired of war. Far from it. You know the ancient Nord word for war? Season unending.
That's kind of cool.
And so it has proved. But regrets are pointless. Here we are. Take your seat at the council table, and let us see what wisdom we can find among these warriors of Skyrim.
I'm worried I'm going to need persuasion checks, but I'm not going to have them. It's definitely... not going to need to go that way. Where do I go? Up here and then to the right?
So, Arngeir, is it? You know why we're here. Are you going to let us in or not?
You're not invited here. You're not welcome here.
We have as much right to be at this council as all of you. More, actually, since we were the ones that put the Dragonborn on this path.
Were you? Hubris of the Blades truly knows no bounds. Not here to rehearse old grudges. The matter at hand is urgent. Aldwyn must be stopped. You wouldn't have called this council if you didn't agree. We know a great deal about the situation and the threat that Aldwyn poses to us all. You need us here if you want this council to succeed. Very well. You may enter.
That was pretty easy. So we do go this way. I'll just follow them. They seem like they know where they're going. Oh, no. Delphine doesn't know where she's going, apparently. So I had to go left and then right, and then I guess it's going to be right over here. Yeah, okay. All right, so I'm going to make a save here quick because I have no idea how this is going to go and if I'm going to need persuasion checks or not. So, yeah, I just jumped and knocked everything. Ooh, I get the King Sea right in the middle up here because I'm Dragonborn. Right? I was supposed to be in this seat? Yeah, I think so. Come on, Delphine. Is she gonna be my right hand? No, I don't know.
Now that everyone is here, please take your seats so we can begin.
This seems like it's not gonna go super well, but we'll find out, I guess.
I hope that we have all come here in the spirit.
You insult us by bringing her to this negotiation. Your chief Talos Hunter.
That didn't take long.
Hear, hear.
I have every right to be at this negotiation. I need to ensure that nothing is agreed to here that violates the terms of the White Gold Concordat.
She's part of the Imperial delegation. You can't dictate who I bring to this council.
No.
Please, if we have to negotiate the terms of the negotiation, we'll never get anywhere.
True that.
Perhaps this would be a good time to get the Dragonborn's input on this matter.
Oh, great.
Beard. The nerve of those Imperial bastards, eh? To think that I would sit down at the same table with that Valmor bitch. Either she walks or I do.
Is there a persuasion? Oh, this is going to be hard. You're right. The Thalmor have no business here. What's the harm? Besides, Tullius doesn't really want her here either. Let's do that one.
Maybe so, but bringing her here is a deliberate provocation. Tullius needs to know I won't be pushed around.
Let Tullius have his way on this. He'll have to give ground later. Ooh. I like that one.
It feels like a mistake to me. But I'll bow to your judgment on this.
Oh, thank you.
But she is to observe, nothing more. We are not negotiating with her. Is that clear?
Ulfric, why so hostile? After all, it's not the Thalmor that's burning your farms and killing your sons.
She's supposed to be on our side?
You know exactly. No. Not this time.
Now that that's settled, may we proceed?
Yes, sit down.
I have something to say first.
Here we go.
The only reason I agreed to attend this council was to deal with the dragon menace. There's nothing else to talk about. Unless the Empire is finally ready to renounce its unjust claim to rule over the free people of Skyrim.
I knew he wouldn't be able to resist.
A temporary truce to allow the Dragonborn here to deal with the dragons, nothing more.
Agreed.
I consider even talking to the Empire a generous gesture.
Did you just come here to make speeches, or can we get down to business?
Yes, let's get this
straight to the point.
Are we ready to proceed? Jarl Ulfric, General Tullius, this council is unprecedented. We are gathered here at the Dragonborn's request. I ask that you all respect the spirit of High Hrothgar. Do your best to begin the process of achieving a lasting peace in Skyrim. Who would like to open the negotiations?
Ulfric?
Yes. Let's get down to it.
Oh, maybe not him.
We want control of Markarth. That's our price for agreeing to a truce.
So that's why you're here, Ulfric? You dare to insult the Greybeards by using this council to advance your own position?
Jarl Elisif.
General, this is outrageous. You can't be taking this demand seriously. I thought we were here to discuss a truce.
Elisif, I said I'd handle it. Ulfric, you can't seriously expect us to give up Markarth at the negotiating table. You hope to gain in council what you've been unable to take in battle, is that it?
I'm sure Jarl Ulfric does not expect something for nothing.
Yes, that'd be entirely out of character.
What in return?
Wait, General, you don't intend to just hand over Markarth to that traitor?
Traitor?
The Empire repays us for our loyalty?
Enough. First, let's be clear. This council wasn't my idea. I think it's a waste of time.
Hey now.
You are a traitor to the Empire and deserve a traitor's death.
Are we really talking about that right now?
We'll negotiate in good faith. Since we're all here at your request, I'd like to hear what you think Markarth is worth.
How about Riften or Dawnstar? I like Riften. It's where the Thieves Guild is at. Dawnstar is pretty crap. So let's say Dawnstar.
In exchange for Markarth, the source of most of Skyrim's silver. Hardly. Riften seems like a better choice to me.
Oh, great.
Easily resupplied from across Lake Honric, plus all the mead we can drink.
There are advantages to gaining Dawnstar. This probably won't work, but let's try.
Not enough to outweigh the loss of Markarth. With the reach in enemy hands, our whole position in Solitude would be threatened.
You asked my opinion, I gave it to you.
Fair enough. I was hoping you could put aside your loyalties for the greater good, but I see you're firmly in Ulfric's camp. Still, having another port would ease our supply situation considerably. Better than nothing, I suppose. But Ulfric will need to offer a lot more if he wants me to give up Markarth without a fight.
Like what?
Markarth will be ours. Now we'll see if there's anything behind your talk of good faith.
I don't blame you, Dragonborn. You made the best of a bad situation. But I can see now that this is not a negotiation at all. I know you, Ulfric. If I hand over Markarth, you'll be ready with a new demand. You'll never defeat the Empire, and you know it. But you're willing to sacrifice thousands
of your own
selfish ambition.
I feel like I messed up.
Soon enough, I'll have you back under the headsman's axe, and this time there won't be any dragon to save you.
As always, the Empire's fine words are worth nothing.
Stop! Are you so blind to our danger that you can't see past your petty disagreements? Here you sit arguing about nothing, while the fate of the land hangs in the balance.
Yeah, Asburn.
You, Delphi. If so, I advise you to tell him to watch his tongue.
He is with me, and I advise you both to listen to what he has to say before you do anything rash.
Don't you understand the danger? Don't you understand what the return of the dragons means? Alduin has returned, the World Eater. Even now he devours the souls of your fallen comrades. He grows more powerful with every soldier slain in your pointless war. Can you not put aside your hatred for even one moment in the face of this mortal danger?
Tell him.
A very pretty speech. But what does
That's
it have to do
you.
With
the... I don't know about the end of the world, but this dragon situation
Everybody hates her.
Has gotten out of hand. If this truce will help the Dragonborn here put an end to that menace, we both gain. Remember that, Ulfric. Now, back to the matter at hand.
Great.
You know as well as I do that we can't hand over Markarth on these terms.
Jaws bones, where will these demands end?
Let's hear it.
We want compensation for the massacre at Carthwaisten.
You slaughtered the very people you claim to be fighting for. True sons of Skyrim would never do such things.
What happened here? I don't know.
And Imperial lies. My men would never stoop to such methods, even in retaliation for your butchery at...
All the blood spilled in this war is on your head.
You've been even-handed so far. What do you say to our demand?
Even-handed. Does that mean... Ulfric should compensate you.
For once you'll actually pay for your crimes. I suppose that's the fairest deal we're likely to get.
It seems we may have an agreement. Jarl Ulfric, General Tullius, these are the terms currently on the table. Markarth will be handed over to Ulfric's forces, Jarl Igmund will step down, and Thangvor Silverblood will become the Jarl of Markarth. Ulfric will allow Imperial forces into the Pale. Skald the Elder will go into exile.
Exile?
Merilis will assume the Jarlship. The Stormcloaks will pay appropriate compensation for the massacre at Carthwaisten.
I figured that's fair for them.
You both agree to this?
I shouldn't agree to terms that so blatantly favor the Empire. I have no choice, though, under the circumstances. But once Alduin is defeated, then it will be the Empire's turn. Remember, Efgir Unslan.
She will, because I'm going to side with you guys.
You should be pleased, Elisif. You've done well for yourself as the Empire's pet yarn. But beware, the Empire's loyalty is fickle. They will tire of this war, and then I will be the one dictating terms to you.
I have nothing to say to that murderer.
Oh, shut up.
You've proven yourself a good friend to Skyrim. I continue to trust that you will do your utmost to safeguard our interests.
Thank you, Jarl Elisif. I appreciate your loyalty.
Jesus, shut up.
The Empire can live with these terms, yes, for a temporary truce, until the dragon menace is dealt with. After that, Ulfric, there will be a reckoning. Count on it.
And that's going to be on Ulfric's side.
We have a lot of work to do.
Giving up Markarth is a heavy price for this truce, Dragonborn. I hope it was worth it.
It will be.
Jarl Balgruuf, I assume you are familiar with the Dragonborn's plan?
Yes, I'm ready to do my part. Just say the word, and my men will help you spring this trap.
All right.
The difficulty remains how to lure a dragon to Dragon's Reach at all?
Well, that's an excellent question. You haven't overlooked that little detail, have you?
Ah, I believe I can be of help here. I anticipated the problem.
Of course you did.
This meeting, I was busy in the library of Skyhaven Temple, an unguessed trove of lost lore. But the important thing is that the blades recorded many of the names of dragons they slew. Cross-referencing this with Delphine's map of dragon burial sites, I believe I've identified one of the dragons that Alduin has raised up.
How is that even possible?
Don't you see? The names of dragons are always three words of power, shouts.
I call
the dragon with a voice. He will hear you wherever he might be.
Why would he come when called?
He's not compelled to, but dragons are prideful by nature and loath to refuse a challenge. Your voice in particular is likely to intrigue this dragon after your victory over Alduin.
So he'd want to come fight me?
It's likely that he will be unable to resist investigating your call.
So what's this dragon's name?
I'm no master of voice like these, worthy gentlemen. But it is written here in the scroll. Odavin, winged snow.
That's a cool name. Snow, call dragon. Word of power learned, hunter, call dragon.
I'm glad.
Word of power learned, wing, call dragon.
I'd give weeks' pay to see the look on Ulfric's face again when he had to swallow the terms of the truce.
There's one more thing. We know about Parthenax.
I know, and I love him. Parthenax is awesome.
That's fine. We needed his help. Now we don't. And it's long past time for him to pay for his crimes. And
no.
He's not just any dragon. He was the right hand of Alduin.
I know,
he
he's good.
Atrocities so infamous they are still remembered thousands of years later.
He's a good guy.
He needs to die. He deserves to die. And it falls to you to kill him.
I'm not gonna do
until
it.
Until he's dead. I'm sorry, but we would dishonor our oaths as blades if we continue to help you.
About Parthenax.
Make your choice, Dragonborn. You're either with us or against us.
Why does he need to die?
Here's the big picture. He helped Alduin enslave our ancestors. He may have betrayed Alduin in the end, but that makes him worse, not better. We can't afford
so short-sighted
the opportunity to betray us in turn. Return to his old master.
Yeah, I don't care about you, Delphine. There's actually a mod which I think is really cool, which lets you basically say, like, no, he's good or whatever. I'm not exactly sure what it does, but all I know is that it makes it so that quest is not stuck like that. Because it's stupid. Totally stupid that I can't get help from them and not kill Parthenax. Like, why should I have to do that? Ooh, everybody's leaving. That's actually kind of cool. I'm going to go see them all leave. There, she's just walking in her Jarl clothes all the way back.
These terms are satisfactory to my government. The truce is unlikely to last long in any case.
Oh, it's just them? I wanted to see Ulfric. But he ran out right quick, so he's if he was here, he's probably farther down. I don't even know if I'd be able to see them actually at this point because they went so far or so early. They dipped out quick. Yeah, they're probably long gone at this point, I think. Yeah, looks like it. Alright, so I believe we finished Season Unending at this point. Yes. So, the next episode we will finish, what is this called? The Fallen, where we go get Odaving and we bring him to Whiterun and trap him in Dragon's Reach. Anyway, guys, if you like this video, make sure to smash that subscribe button for new videos every single day, and don't forget to give that like button some love. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching, and let's continue to create the greatest gaming community in the world.